Hello, everyone, and Happy New Year. Welcome to the SOS Show Live with Mary Evans. I'm your host with a strong belief that there is power in sharing stories. SOS stands for Share Our Stories. So if you have a story to share, I want to hear it. Please like and comment. Today, we have an amazing show. Let's watch this short commercial. So today, we have an amazing guest. I know if you have never struggled with moving forward, I know that you know somebody that has. Today is about a show about moving forward. Happy New Year to you. It's a new day. It's a new year. And I would like to welcome to the show, Ms. Tomiko Reynolds. Our audience just going crazy, girl. They knew you was going to be on the show. How are you?
I'm great. How are you doing?
Good. I'm so excited to talk about this topic with you moving forward because it's deeper. You know, a lot of things that you have did in your life I can relate to, and I'm trying to get there. You inspire me, and I must say I'm jealous at the same time because sometimes we can be stuck. If you're listening to me and you hear me and you understand me, sometimes we can be stuck when it comes to moving forward. So we're going to break this down tonight. And your story, I want to talk about, because listen to this, girl. And if y'all relate to us, please talk back to us in the comments. I've been trying to leave Michigan for a long time. We had my mindset ready to go. But because of my relationship with my parents, my mother, nieces, nephews, sisters, I've always was turned around and had to make a U-turn, sweetheart. I want you, because I know you can inspire someone. Tell us about, when did you say, first let's talk about, had you planned to move and leave your hometown before it didn't go? Had that ever happened?
Mary, you don't even know. Well, it all started when I was a teenager. My whole dream was to always be a fashion designer. And I already knew I was going to New York. Let's start there. So when I graduated from college, I said, oh, I'm still going. Only thing was, I was expecting my first son. And my mother told me, you're not moving to a new city with a new baby. You don't know anybody. But I never had that fear to, you know, to explore unknown territories. So I said I was going. But it's always God got something else planned for you. So around that time is when my sister ended up getting sick, as you know. So I ended up staying and helping raise my nieces. And then I had to wait for my son to graduate because, of course, you know, you don't want to uproot your kids from school. And so I said, you know what, when he graduates, it's all about me. I'm doing it. And that was around the time when I said, I'm going for it. And I just was putting out resumes and filling out jobs. And I actually had two different destinations, but New York would just so happen to come up. And so they called me back at the last minute. I was on my way to Cancun for my birthday. And they called me about a job. So I had to really, really move fast. I really didn't have time to kind of do a lot of research on areas. I actually flew out here twice. I drove once by myself. I was determined because I said, if not now, then when?
I have and a question God, for you. Did you have any family there?
No family. No friends. None of that.
You packed up like the Beverly Hillbillies and said, I'm ready. I'm doing this now. For anybody that's listening that is on their mind, have to this day, have you had any regrets?
No. The only thing that really comes about is me missing my family. But I come home, if you know me, I'm home at least once a month. It's just a short flight out. The flight is not very expensive. And so I come home, I do my clients, I see my family, and it's not much different.
Okay, let's talk about this. You didn't know anybody. You didn't have any family members. You went, new job. You have your apartment. Tell us, what did that feel like? Just talk about your first week there. You went to work, you came home, it's nobody. Let's talk that out, because I know it's other people who are afraid to make that leap because they didn't have family, they didn't have friends. Tell us, what was that like for you?
So the first week that I was here, it was crazy because I had just come back from my birthday trip in Cancun. And I started work the very next day. So I was like pushing it. I had boxes everywhere. I didn't get a chance, which I knew I was going to take time to unpack, but I had boxes everywhere on my first day of work. I packed so well. I was able to pull out my outfit for work. And so when I came home, I was just busy unpacking, putting the house the way that I wanted it. So I really wasn't in a rush. Of course, I was on the phone with my family the whole week, you know, I would probably say the whole month back and forth, you know, talking on a regular basis. And then I just started meeting people at work and becoming a social butterfly. And here we are 3 years later.
3 years later. And I know from talking to you and as well as your mother, we talk all the time. And she did mention to me, I remember one conversation we had, she said, much as she's going to miss you, she really believed that you deserve to go out and live the life that you think you want or dreamed of. She will miss you. I know you guys are close. And that always has been my situation. At the moment that you decided to leave, Tomiko, how did you tell her? I know people be like, y'all grown, what are you so worried about? But they have to understand the relationship that we have with our parents to understand that question. And I know you understand something similar that I'm struggling with.
Oh, yes, Mary. We are very alike in that aspect, where we have spoiled these mothers of ours. And if my mother's listening, I know she knows. She is full rotten, and but so am I.
Yeah.
And a lot of times, as individuals, we kind of live for our parents, and
amen.
We want to.
Amen.
And we want to do what makes them happy.
Repeat that for the people in the back.
We want to live for our parents, and you know, you want to make them proud and happy, and do what it takes, you know, whatever they need sometimes. And at the same time, omitting the things that you need or might want.
Yes.
And so I have finally come to the realization that it is time for me to go and take that leap. I did it before when I went off to college. I didn't know anybody at school.
Yes.
So one person from my hometown. But other than that, I didn't know anybody. And so it was very hard. The move was, it was hard in the aspects of leaving my family, but when God is in it, the doors, they just open up for you. And it just made a way, and it was easy. My brother and my son came, no questions asked, packed up my truck and moved me across town, across the country.
I am so happy for you. I was looking at some Facebook photos and I came across two memes that remind me of you, and I want you to read them. And this is what I used to say. Look, dear Lord, don't let me go backwards. And if I fall, please let it be forward. Amen.
Ooh, amen.
And
amen.
This is you all day long. I'm going to let you read this, Tomiko.
Bless the woman who chases no one, needs no validation, and handles her business like a boss. Pretty much so. She silently stepped out of the race that she never wanted to be in, found her own lane, and proceeded to win.
Now, that's you all day. And when we talk about a race, I mean that race. When we say we always want to live, not everyone, but because our relationships always wanted to never do anything that would stress out my parents, and me leaving would stress them out, no doubt, right? But ladies, gentlemen, are you listening? At one point, we have to decide that we have to do some of the things that make us happy. When I say moving forward, a new day and a new year, and do it in such a way that we could strategically plan not hurting them as much as possible. So I want to ask you this. So after you decided to move and you gone, because I know, if I know Miss Mona Lisa, I know she dropped some tears at one time. Miss Regina has a comment. This is Mom. I'm enjoying the interview. I love it. I would love to as well. Look like Miss Regina would love. This is Mama. I hear you, Regina. Tariko, anybody that is out there listening right now that's struggling with that move because of relationship with family, if you had one thing to tell them, what would that be?
Do it now. Do it now. Do not wait. Life is short. 2020 showed us that life is not promised to you. It's very short. If it's something that's yearning down inside of you, I say go for it. Don't look back.
When you were looking for the job, what site did you use, in any particular site, and whoever sort of called you first, you did interviews? How did you find a job so quickly?
I was on all types of sites. Actually, it really wasn't, I would say it probably wasn't that quick, maybe 5-6 months. Okay. I had been looking, just throwing my resume out there. I was going to a whole nother state. Okay. And then New York actually just started coming up as I was applying to jobs. And then I got a call one day while I was at my other job. Don't ever leave your job until you have a job. Okay. Let me put that out
Good advice.
So I got this call and the lady's talking about, you remember applying for this job. I didn't even remember because it was so many jobs I had applied to. But again, when God is in it, it just flows and the doors just open like that. And she asked me how soon I can get out there. And I was like, give me 48 hours and I'll be there.
That's when you're ready. Now, I'm going to take Marsha Easley. I am ready to go mentally, but have too much to handle here. And that happens. And when you plan it, like you're saying, God is in it, you start planning that move. In the end of the show, I'm going to talk about some plans that but you have to start planning. And guess what? Sometimes you have to plan that move and start making moves and nobody even know what you're doing. Nobody even know that you're moving forward to go. Because guess what? Raymond Matthews say it's all a part of his plan. Yes, it is. Because guess what? Sometimes you have to move in silence and prepare yourself for the move. And when the time is right, you let everybody know. You understand what I'm saying?
That's right.
I'm going to take this interview a step further. You did this thing in this move. Thank God you met people before this pandemic, because moving and dating is already a scary thing when you don't know a lot of people, no matter where you at. Let's talk about being down there in New York, COVID and dating. Girl, how's that going?
It's not going well over here. I'm not doing much dating over here in New York.
Okay. It's slowed
down. Not here in New York.
Okay. Rachel Joy Holiday. God does not give us the spirit of fear. Amen. That is so true.
Oh yeah. Now that's one of my besties too. She did it before me. She took the leap and jumped out there to Dallas. We both said we was leaving, but she did it before I did. So she took that leap too.
And if your mom is listening, Mrs. Mona Lisa, bless her heart. I'm so proud of her, because this is Mona with Regina. Okay. She's doing pretty good, knowing all the things that she just wanted you to be happy. And we talked about this. And the reason why I wanted to do the show is because I know we're not the only one that sometimes we feel stuck and wanted to move forward, but we just don't want to make any of our family members unhappy.
Right.
So now that you have inspired me, and it's okay to be jealous as long as you know you're aware, right?
No, just anything you need, I'm there for you. Come out here if you want to, stay with it and see how I do move around New York.
Yes.
I love you. You can do it. I know you're going to do well.
So let me tell you about the first time that I did try to move. The first time I moved, my sister and I are 11 years apart. I told my mother, at that time I was trying to go to Texas. My mother cried so hard to Tomiko. I said, okay, what is your biggest problem? She said, I can't, because my sister had three kids back to back very young. I'm like you. I was helping her take care of my sister and the kids. She said, because I can't do this alone. I need your help. Do you know I went to my sister and convinced her to go with me? I said, okay, I'll take my sister, her three kids, my two kids. I'm like you. I'm not afraid. Fear don't stop me. I went back to her and told her, okay, I'm going first. I'm going to send for a lot of the kids. Girl, she cried out. She hit the floor this time. I said, what's the problem now? You told me you didn't want me to leave them. I'm going to send for them. And you're still crying. So that's the come I say, when I watch you, you inspire me. But I've decided to take the leap, and I want you to hear my favorite song, because this is what I'm doing, Tomiko.
Okay, all right.
You hear that? I'm taking putting it in my car.
That was my theme song for years.
I'm headed to Atlanta. My husband and I, that's like I say, you inspire me. We are so much alike. And I can't be the only one that's struggling with the things that we're going through. And that's why I wanted to bring you on the show. We're going to bring you back. I'm going to go. And guess what? Mama will be okay. She could come visit me. I'll come back. And ladies and gent, if you out here living your life for someone else, it's time. I'm sorry. We love y'all, but it's time to go. Thank you so much. I'll bring you back on Coffee and Conversation. Great topic. I've learned, Tomiko, if you have a short, fun show, people watch the whole show. The longer you go, the more they fall off. So we always gonna come in together, hit them hard.
Okay.
Get in and get out. I look forward to the next show with you on Coffee and Conversation. What was that topic? Let's let them know now. What topic did you send to me, Tomiko? Let's go.
My mother's gonna love this because she kind of gave it up. What did we say?
The 90 day rule
working for you. And yes. This is for the ladies.
The 90 day rule working. Tomiko, sort of explain that 90 day rule for the ones that don't understand.
So the Steve Harvey's 90 day rule when you're dating, and the 90 day rule is don't give the cookie up.
It worked for you. That's going to be a great topic. You guys, please stay tuned. I'm bringing Tomiko Reynolds back to the SOS Show Live with Mary Evans. If you have not yet liked the page, please do so. It's a page, a Black platform for us to reveal our stories straight and uncut. It's all about us, Black economics, Black peace, Black love. See you next show. And thank you, Tomiko.
Happy New Year, everybody. You're welcome. Thank you for having me.
Yes.